गुड मॉर्निंग फ्रेंड्स. सो इन दिस वीडियो लेक्चर वी विल स्टडी अबाउट द बेसिक्स ऑफ सी प्रोग्रामिंग लैंग्वेज. सो इन बेसिक ऑफ सी प्रोग्रामिंग लैंग्वेज वी विल स्टडी अबाउट द इंट्रोडक्शन टू सी लैंग्वेज. देन आफ्टर इंट्रोडक्शन वी विल स्टडी द डिफरेंट स्टेप्स विच आर यूज्ड टू क्रिएट अ सी program and get the output. After that we will study about the installation of C compiler. After installation of C compiler we will run a basic C program. Okay, so we will start with the introduction to C language. Okay, so as we know that C is a powerful general purpose programming language. It can be used to develop software like operating systems, databases, compilers and so on. C programming is an excellent language to learn to program for beginners. So after that, you must know that who is the father of C programming language or who developed the C language. So C language is developed by Dennis Ritchie in 1972 for Unix operating system. The Unix operating system and most Unix applications are written in C and today is still one of the most widely used programming language around. So this is all about the introduction to C language. Next, we will move to the steps to create a C program and how to get the output. Okay, so in C programming, there are different steps to be followed for any C program to create and get the output. Now, the question is, what are these steps? So, these steps are, first step is create, second step is compile, third step is execute or run, fourth step is get the output. Okay. Now, to write a C program, first of all, there must be a C compiler in your system. Okay, so if you want to create, compile and execute a C program by your own, you have to install a C compiler in your machine. Then you can start to execute your own C programs in your machine. Okay, so I will tell you about the installation of C compiler step by step. So after installing the C compiler in your machine, you can create, compile and execute a C program. Okay, otherwise if you don't want to install C or C++ compiler in your machine, then you can refer online compiler. There are number of online compilers available on the internet. So you can refer those types of compiler to execute a C program. Okay, so these are the four steps. You should remember that there are four steps that are used to create a C program. Okay, then we will move to the next, installation of C compiler. Okay, so as I told you that for running or to execute a C program, you need a C compiler. Clear? Now the question is how that C compiler will be installed or where that compiler will be available. Okay, so there are number of C compilers available online. You can download directly from the internet. Okay, like Turbo C, Dev C++. So nowadays Dev CPP or Dev C++ is very widely used C compiler. Okay, so you can directly download this Dev CPP software from the internet. So how you can download it from the internet? So first of all, open your browser. Okay, then simply you have to search Dev CPP download. Okay, so you have to click on the first link, that is Dev CP C++ download. Okay, so after clicking on this link, this window will open. There is a download link. You can download or you can simply click on this download. After downloading or after clicking on download, your setup will be saved in your system. So I have already downloaded this setup or this compiler. You can see on my desktop. Okay, this is the setup of dev cpp. Okay, now the question is how to install this C compiler. Simply double click on this software, then click on yes. Okay, so your setup is loading. So when your setup will load, or when your setup loading is complete, it will ask you to select a language. So you have to select your language according to your preference. Then you have to click on OK. Then you have to agree, or you have to click on I agree, the license agreement. Then click on next. So after clicking on next, it will show you the destination folder. Okay, destination folder means where your C compiler files will be saved. Okay, so by default it will be saved on C drive. If you want to change, simply you have to click and you have to select the particular area or particular space where you want to install the setup. Okay, then click on install. So it will take hardly 15 to 20 seconds. Okay, so your installation is going to complete. Okay, so your installation is complete. So at the end you have to click on finish. Okay, before clicking on finish, either you can tick the checkbox or untick the checkbox. If you want to run the dev cpp or run the compiler, simply you have to tick this checkbox and click on finish. Okay, so after clicking on finish, it will ask you again the language. Again, you can select the language according to your preference. Okay, so mine is English. So click on next. Then after clicking on next, it will ask you to select the theme, color and icons. By default, font is Consolas, color is Classic Plus, icons is New Look. So it is better. So click on next and then click on OK. So now your C compiler is opened. Now you have to write a simple basic C program on this compiler. Okay, so you have to run a basic C program. Okay, so open your C compiler. Now simple basic program, we will print or we will write a C program which display hello world in the output window. Okay, if you are beginner of C language, then you must know that all syntax and commands in C programming are case sensitive. Okay, and also each statement should be ended with semicolon, which is a statement terminator. Okay, so please remember, if you are using semicolon at any statement, it means your statement gets terminated. So let us write a C program to print a hello world. So first of all, we will write hash include stdio.h. Now what does indicate hash include stdio.h? This is a preprocessor command that includes standard input output header file from the C library before compiling a C program. Okay, next is integer main. Okay, now what is integer main? This is the main function from where execution of any C program begins. Okay, then you have to use start curly brace. Okay, so start curly brace indicates the beginning of the main function. Okay, then you have to print the statement hello world. Okay, so what is the function of printf? The printf command prints the output on the screen. Okay, now as I earlier told you that in this program we will display hello world in the output screen. Whichever statement you want to print on the output screen, you have to write that statement in the printf. Okay, then next we will write the return 0. Okay, now return zero command terminates C program, or you can say main function, and it will return zero. And at the end, curly brace close. Now curly brace close indicates the end of the main function. So this is the simple basic program to print the hello world statement on the output screen. So after writing the program, you have to click on execute menu and compile and run. So when you click on compile and run, it will ask you to save your program. So my program name is C program. Okay, then click on save. Okay, so you can see the output window. This is the output window. You can see here the statement we have printed hello world is displayed in the hello world. Okay, so I'm repeating again, whichever statement you want to show on the output window, you have to write that statement on the printf command. Okay, now I want to print my name is Salman Khan. Clear? Again, compile and run. So it will display my name is Salman Khan. Okay, so I hope this program is clear to you. So we have studied about the introduction to C language, the different steps to create C programs and how to get the output, installation of C compiler, and at last we run a simple basic C program on C compiler. So I hope it is clear to you. Okay, so thank you. Thank you very much.